Welcome to Krishna IAS, and today I am going to discuss with you about an important question of a BPSC 65th exam. And that question is, explain meaning and a scope of economic anthropology with a special reference to formalist and substantive school of thought. So basically, this is very important question asked by BPSC. And when we try to analyze about the nature of that question, this question is a complex for BPSC student. So today I will try to explain how to write answer about that question. So before we are going to write about the answer of that question, you have understood it has three important major components. First important component is meaning and a scope of economic anthropology. Second important concept, formalist school of thought. And third important concept is substantive school of thought. So it has three important components. So try to understand one by one these component. So first important thing is that when you try to write about introduction about a meaning and a scope of economic anthropology, so it has two important things. One is, what is the meaning of economic anthropology? So simply, you can see economic anthropology is a branch of sociocultural anthropology which deals with the study of economic organization, economic activity of primitive people cross-culturally. Secondly, when you try to write about the scope of economic anthropology, so that the scope of economic anthropology gradually expanded, right? Because when you write about the introduction, economic anthropology is a branch of sociocultural anthropology which deals with the study of economic activity of mankind cross-culturally. So you understand three important steps or stage. First stage is the development of traditional economic anthropology. So in traditional economic anthropology, basically that was developed in 19th century, we mainly focus to a study about primitive economy. And when we are going to study about primitive economy, we try to understand primitive economy in socio-cultural perspective. So integration of economic life with the social and cultural life is very important thing when we try to understand about the meaning of economic anthropology and a scope of economic anthropology. That was traditional economic anthropology that was developed in 19th century. So in this period, a scope of economic anthropology was very limited, because basically economic anthropologists mainly interested to study about natural environment of primitive people. Secondly, they also give focus about nature influenced about the economic activity of primitive people. Secondly, they also study about the technology, because the technological development is integrated with their natural environment. Third, they also study about their social organization, because in primitive economy, there was no any concept of labor organization. And supply of labor done by kinship or their social organization. So economic activity is not only economic activity, that is social process in primitive people. And basically their economy is subsistence economy. So that whole economic system based on concept of reciprocity, and they also believe that whole economic production influenced by their supernatural, because that depend on the bliss of supernatural. So when anthropologists try to understand about their economic life, their economic organization, their economic activity, they follow these types of, these kinds of approach. And through sociocultural perspective, we try to understand about economic organization, economic activity, economic life of the people of primitive society. So that was basically developed in 19th century. So at first, if I write about that thing, that important concept, that important facts, after that in 20th century, in early 20th century, there was a development of new thought, new views, new method in economic anthropology, and in which first important thing is development of formalist view in economic anthropology. So second important component of that question about a formalist school of thought or formalist view regarding economic anthropology. So before you are going to write answer, at first you try to understand about what is that formalist view, how that view developed, and what was the impact of that view on the study of economic anthropology, their meaning and their scope. So two important personality you have remembered. First is Raymond Firth and second is M.G. Herskovich. So Raymond Firth, in his famous work Primitive Polynesian Economy, 1927, he founded the view, the theory of formalist economic anthropology. And he enhanced that view in his famous work, Primitive Economy of New Zealand Maoris, in 1929. In 1940, M.G. Herskovich, in his famous work, The Economic Life of the People of Primitive, The Economic Life of Primitive People, in 1914. M.G. Herskovich also supported the view of Raymond Firth and formalist school of thought. So basically, formalist school of thought was based on some important concept. And first important thing is that they said that theories of formal economics or classical economics are useful for the understanding of both primitive as well as modern economic system. So they said that theory of demand and supply, theory of scarcity of resources and selection of needs, theory of maximization of profit, role of market, are very important. These are very important concept or theory for the understanding of primitive economy as well as modern economy, because if we apply these types of theory for the understanding of primitive economic system, we can better understand about primitive economy. And they also said that a statistical method and mathematical method, and quantitative data are also useful for the understanding of primitive economy. So that was the basic thought of a formalist economic anthropologist. An important case study you can mention, and that was very important for the answer writing of this question. Soltex was American anthropologist, and he had done a study in Guatemalan Indian society for testing hypothesis of formalist school of thought in 1953. So in 1953, Soltex, in his famous work penny capitalist, a Guatemalan Indian economy, said that Guatemalan society is a primitive society and their economy is at the stage of primitive. But they are using these concepts which proposed by formalists like theory of demand and supply, theory of scarcity of resources, maximization of profit, role of market, mathematical statistical method and quantitative data. So on the basis of that case study, Soltek said that this concept is useful for the understanding of primitive economic system. So that is new thing in economic anthropology, and due to introduction and due to application of formalist view, the meaning and scope of economic anthropology, the meaning and scope of economic anthropology, both are changed. And due to the impact of formalist in economic anthropology, we started studying both modern and primitive economic system, and by the application of these theories. But in 1957, Carl Polanyi, in his famous work, Trade and Market in Early Empire, criticized about formalist view of economic anthropology. Carl Polanyi said that theory of formalist economy and theory of classical economy are not useful for the understanding of primitive economy, because primitive people producing something for fulfillment of the need of their society, not for the need of market, which is regulated through theory of demand and supply. So primitive people fulfill their social need through economic production, not they fulfill the need of market. So there is no scope of application of theory of demand and supply for the understanding of primitive economy. Second, he said that there are no scarcity of resources in primitive society because their needs are limited. So they easily fulfill their needs without selection between their resources and need. Third, he said that primitive people doing their economic activity for the fulfillment of the need of their society, and they are not influenced by the theory of maximization of profit, because they are doing economic activity for the fulfillment of basic need of their community. So they are not influenced by the theory of maximization of profit. And then he said that the role of market is quite different in primitive society, because in primitive society, market is social place where primitive people not only fulfill their economic need, but also fulfill their social, their cultural, their political needs. So the role of market is quite different in primitive society than modern society. And then he said that because anthropologists study society, economy, through fieldwork method, through participant observation, by which they gathered qualitative as well as quantitative data. So there is limited scope of application of mathematical statistical method for the understanding of primitive economy. So through that, Carl Polanyi rejected the view of formalist economic anthropologist. And Carl Polanyi said that if we try to understand about primitive economy, we have to understand primitive economy in socio-cultural perspective, which based on cross-cultural study. And therefore, he said that we have to study social and cultural perspective of the people of primitive society for the understanding of their economic activity, economic organization, or economic life. Because their economic life is the part of their socio-cultural life, and that is fully integrated with their society, fully integrated with their culture, and that regulated through cultural rule, social rule, not regulated through economic rule like demand and supply, right? So he rejected, and he again gave focus to a study of economic anthropology in sociocultural anthropology, and he also gave focus to a study of primitive society as a core subject matter of economic anthropology, right? So this is substantive school of thought. That thought is supported by many famous anthropologists like Branislav Malinowski. But here you have to write what happened after development of these types of school. So basic thing is that due to development of these types of thought, meaning and scope of economic anthropology are changed. Now, economic anthropology is a branch of sociocultural anthropology which deals with comparative study of modern as well as primitive society, but mainly focused to a study of primitive society in cross-cultural perspective. But there are development of new component, new element in economic anthropology, because nowadays in economic anthropology we not only study primitive economy, we also study rural economy, we also study industrial economy, corporate economy, we also study about economic life of people of urban society in urban anthropology. So due to that thing, the scope of economic anthropology became very broad, and now it is not only theoretical science but also applied science. So knowledge and data gathered by economic anthropology are useful for the welfare of mankind, and therefore now economic anthropology become very broad, very expanded. So through that you can write your answer.